Hello everyone, in this video let us discuss the steps of modified radical mastectomy. In the module on breast, I have already discussed what is radical mastectomy and what is modified radical, so I am not repeating it here. In this video, we are just going to discuss the steps of MRM because it is asked in your exam. So with any other surgical procedure, as I have already discussed, you need to mention those three important points. One is anesthesia, the second is position of the patient, and the third is antiseptic, cleaning and draping. So these three points you should mention before you begin to say or write any operative procedure. So anesthesia in case of breast is going to be general anesthesia. We cannot carry out mastectomy under spinal general anesthesia, and since it's general anesthesia, we need to carry out an endotracheal intubation. The position of the patient, we are operating the breast, so it is going to be definitely supine. And an important point here in MRM means we are going to dissect the breast as well as clear the level 1, 2 and 3 axillary lymph nodes. So we need to access the axilla. If we keep the patient supine, say suppose in the position of appendicectomy, we cannot access the axilla, right? So suppose I am carrying out an operation, an MRM on the right breast. So we have to extend the right arm of the patient and support it on an arm table so that we can access the axilla. So we are operating the right breast, and then we are operating on the right axilla, and that is why the patient is supine and the arm on the operating site of the operating site is supported on an arm table. So we have those extensions in an OT table for resting the arm, so we are using that on the side of the operation. And antiseptic cleaning and draping is as usual performed. Now before beginning the incision, the next stage is usually incision. Before beginning the incision, we need to delineate the lump or mass, because we are carrying out MRM for that, right? So we need to delineate the lump or mass. After that, we begin with the proper surgical procedure, and definitely it begins with incision. So what is the incision of MRM going to look like? The incision of MRM is a transverse elliptical incision. So this type of incision is transverse and this is an ellipse. So if you combine them, it becomes something like this, right? It is transverse and it is elliptical. So it is a transverse elliptical incision encircling the nipple and areola and encompassing 5 cm skin margin around the mass. So we need to keep a margin of 5 cm all around the mass, right? So let us look at a diagram here to understand better. So the patient is supine. The arm, this is, we are operating on the right breast. So the right arm is, say, supported on an arm table, and we have made an incision. The red line is our incision. Suppose I add the mass here. Suppose this is the mass in the breast that we are talking about, the blue marking. This is the nipple and areola complex, NAC. This is NAC, nipple areola complex, and we have made our incision. Now, after we make our incision, suppose like this, what is going to happen? We get two parts here, right? And we need to raise the skin flaps. That is our next step. The next step is raising of skin flaps. So once we have made this incision, you can imagine that we are going to have two parts. We have an upper part, we have an upper part, and we have a lower part. So the skin flaps are raised by sharp dissection. So we use scissors and scalpel to raise the skin flaps. They are raised by sharp dissection. And what is the plane of the dissection? That is, we include the subcutaneous fat or subcutaneous tissue along with the skin. So the plane is between the plane of dissection is between subcutaneous tissue and mammary fat. So, subcutaneous fat and mammary fat, that is the plane. So, we include the subcutaneous tissue and fat along with the skin flaps. Now, we have seen that we have an upper and a lower flap. So, the upper skin flap is raised till the clavicle. So, this is the clavicle. So, we raise this upper skin flap till the clavicle, and the lower skin flap is raised till the upper quadrant of rectus sheath. So, we raise the upper skin flap till the clavicle and the lower skin flap till the upper quadrant of rectus sheath. And naturally, there are going to be bleeding points because we are carrying out a sharp dissection. So, the bleeding points should be taken care of. And how are we going to take care of the bleeding points? We are going to use the diathermy pencil and just cauterize them. Bleeding points should be cauterized. This is a point that is important for all steps because there are a lot of perforative vessels in this region and they are going to bleed. So, we need to take care of the bleeding, and you have to mention this point in all steps. Just keep that in mind. So, let us look at a diagram after we have raised the skin flap. So, this is the diagram. We have raised the skin flap. We started with this part. This was our beginning, and we have raised the upper skin flap. As you can see, this is the upper skin flap containing subcutaneous fat also, the yellowish ones. And we have held it with skin hooks. These are skin hooks. And we have raised it till the clavicle. This is the direction of the clavicle. So, we are holding it, you know, sort of vertically. This is sort of vertical and this is a horizontal plane, if you can appreciate. And we are now raising the lower flap. This was our mass, for example, and this is the nipple areola complex. This is the breast tissue, and we are raising the lower flap. So, just keep these diagrams in your mind so that you can visualize. Of course, the best method, as I have always mentioned in all the videos of operatives, the best method to learn operatives is not any book, not any atlas, not any YouTube video, but to be in the operating theater yourself, right? So, please visit the operation theater of your hospital and please do watch at least 2 mastectomies so that you can recall, you know, from your memory during the exam. That is the best method to learn. These are to augment your knowledge. After you have watched an operation in your hospital, just come and watch this video, and before your exam also watch this video so that you can remember the whole thing. So let's move on to the next step. So we have raised the skin flap, and the next step is going to be raising the breast. So what do? We dissect the breast. From what part? What is the breast lying on? Yes, which muscle? Pectoralis major. So, we dissect the breast from the fascia covering the pectoralis major muscle. So, we have the pectoralis major muscle, we have a fascia covering the pectoralis major, and then we have the breast. So, we are dissecting the breast off from the pectoralis major fascia. So, what are the margins of our breast dissection? As usual, above we are dissecting from the level of clavicle, just like the skin flaps. Below, again just like skin flaps, we are dissecting till the upper quadrant of rectus sheath. Medially, yes, can you guess? It's quite obvious, it has to be the midline. So, medially we are dissecting till the midline or sternum, and laterally, this is important, the lateral margin is going to be the latissimus dorsi muscle. So, latissimus dorsi is a muscle of the back, and it, you know, comes till here. So, we are dissecting the breast above at the level of the clavicle, then at the level of the upper quadrant of rectus sheath. Here, medially, it is going to be the midline or sternum. and laterally it is going to be the latissimus dorsi muscle. So let us look at a diagram here. So here you can see this is the upper skin flap. This is the breast tissue that we are removing. And can you guess what is this red color structure that we can see? Yes, it is the pectoralis major muscle. So we are removing the breast along these margins, but we are not removing it completely. We are letting the breast, hang laterally, keeping the axillary tail in continuity. Alright, so we have dissected the breast, so we have the breast mass like this. We don't lift it off completely, we let it hang along the, this is the axillary tail of Spence. So we let the breast hang laterally along the axillary tail of Spence, because in modified radical mastectomy we not only dissect the breast but we also explode the axilla and carry out axillary dissection. So before removing the breast we complete the axillary part and finally remove the whole thing together. So if you have watched a mastectomy in your hospital, you must have observed that the surgeons let the breast hang laterally and then carry out the axillary dissection. So naturally our next step is going to be the axillary dissection. So what we do, we clear the loose areolar tissue from the lateral border of pectoralis major muscle. And this exposes the pectoralis minor muscle. So after we clear the loose areolar tissue from the lateral border of pectoralis major, we can see the pectoralis minor muscle, and we retract the pectoralis major muscle. So let us have a look at a diagram here. So just look at this diagram. I hope you can identify the structures here. The yellowish parts are, as usual, the fat. We are not going to be bothered about them here. The muscle, this muscle which has been retracted, this muscle is the pectoralis major, yes. And the muscle underlying that is the pectoralis minor, right? And this blue structure, what is it? It's a very important structure that we can appreciate. Yes, it is the axillary vein. And you should be very careful while dissecting anything near the axillary vein. So after we have cleared the loose areolar tissue from the lateral border of pectoralis major, we clear the loose areolar tissue from axilla and level 1 axillary lymph nodes. We have studied about the axillary lymph nodes in the module on breast. So if you don't know the anatomy now, please go and refer to that video. And a word of precaution in all these steps that we are beginning in axillary dissection, it is that we should be very careful when we are dissecting near the axillary vein and axillary artery. We need to be very careful, because if we injure the axillary vein and artery or something like that, or an important nerve, it can lead to quite a lot of complications. So what is going to be our next step? We have to deal with the pectoralis minor. Now here a very important point is that there are a few modifications of modified radical mastectomy as well. If we are talking about Patty's mastectomy, then the pectoralis minor is divided from its insertion. And where is it inserted? In the coracoid process. But if you are talking about Auchincloss, these are various modifications of modified radical mastectomy. Here the pectoralis minor is retracted and not divided from its insertion. So these are the two small modifications regarding the pectoralis minor, and just be careful whether the examiner has asked you Petty's or whether he has mentioned nothing about it. If nothing is mentioned, you may just write Petty's, or you may just mention this difference as well. So let us have a look at a diagram of the next stage after we have divided the pectoralis minor. So we have divided the pectoralis minor muscle. This is the pectoralis major as with the previous diagram. And we can see the ribs, and this is the serratus anterior muscle. We cannot see the pectoralis minor because we have divided it. And you can appreciate the axillary vein as usual. And most importantly, you can see this yellowish structure that I have drawn. It is the long thoracic nerve. This is very important. This is the long thoracic nerve. So in this stage, what we do, after we have divided the pectoralis minor, we remove the level 2 and 3. We had removed 1, we now remove level 2 and 3 lymph nodes and loose areolar tissue from the axilla. So, a word of caution, as with the axillary vessels, here there is a word of caution regarding the long thoracic nerve. If you injure the long thoracic nerve, the nerve to serratus anterior, what is going to happen? Yes, winging of scapula. So, we need to be careful about long thoracic nerve. So, we have to identify it. We can see it in the lateral chest wall as in the diagram. So, we have to be careful about the long thoracic nerve and preserve it. And another thing is that the dissection of lymph node and loose areolar tissue in the axilla is kept confined to the anterior and inferior aspect of axillary vein. We do not remove anything above the axillary vein. Above the axillary vein, we do not proceed for any dissection. And the lateral dissection, as I have mentioned before, is carried up to the anterior border of latissimus dorsi. So, we have dissected out the level 1, 2, 3 lymph nodes as well as the loose areolar tissue in the axilla. And we had also dissected out the breast. Now, we remove the whole thing. So, let us look at a diagram of this stage. So, we have cleared the lymph nodes 1, 2 and 3. This is the breast dissection that we have carried out and it is hanging laterally. So, we will just remove it. We can see the long thoracic nerve as before, LTN, long thoracic nerve. This is the serratus anterior. This is the pectoralis major and this is the axillary vein. And we can see another vein here, this one. This is the thoracodorsal vein. Thoracodorsal vein, and along with it we have a nerve here again, the yellow one. It is the thoracodorsal nerve. So we need to preserve the thoracodorsal nerve as well. The thoracodorsal nerve is the nerve supply of which muscle? Yes, the latissimus dorsi. So we need to preserve the nerve supply to the serratus anterior, that is long thoracic nerve or nerve to serratus anterior, and thoracodorsal nerve, that is nerve to latissimus dorsi. So, in any operative procedure, we should try to preserve as many important structures as possible. Sometimes we have to sacrifice a sensory nerve. What is that? It is the intercostobrachial nerve, right? And it provides sensation to the upper inner aspect of the arm. So, sometimes we have to sacrifice that nerve, and in the postoperative period, the patient presents with loss of sensation in the inner aspect of the upper part of the arm. So, but since it's sensory, it's fine, but we cannot sacrifice nerves to muscles, right? So, we need to be careful about the long thoracic nerve as well as the thoracodorsal nerve. So, what is the last step? Yes, closure. But before that, in all the operative procedures, we have to ensure proper hemostasis. That is, nothing is bleeding. And the next step is closure. So, before closing the skin incision, we insert a suction drain. Insertion of suction drain. One tube kept in axilla and another tube kept underneath the breast flap. Otherwise, fluid is going to accumulate there, causing a seroma, that is fluid accumulation at the operative site. So, that is why we have to insert a suction drain, the drain which would suck the fluid at the operative site, that is a vacuum drain. So, we keep one tube in the axilla and one tube underneath the breast flap, and the skin is closed. So, let us have a look at a diagram here. So, this is how it's going to look like. This is the contralateral breast. This is the area which has been operated. So, we can see the incision here which has been closed, and we can see the drain with two tubes, and we connect it to a vacuum drain, and we activate the vacuum so that fluid from this operative site starts to drain here, and we remove the in post-op we remove the drain after less than 40 ml cullets for two consecutive days post-op days. So in operative procedure, you have to mention about post-op care also a little, because that is a part of the operation, right? You cannot neglect post-operative care. It is a part of surgery as well. So in post-operative period, just mention that we have to remove the suture after around 5 to 7 days. Suture removal is 5 to 7 days. Drain, I've already mentioned. Then we have to encourage the use of the arm. Encourage use of the arm. And of course, antisepsis is to be followed in the postoperative period with antibiotics and everything. So just mention in brief about the postoperative care along with any operative procedure that you are going to mention. So with this, we finish our discussion on the steps of modified radical mastectomy. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much.